إن الحمد لله نحمده ونستعينه ونستغفره ونعوذ بالله من شرور أنفسنا ومن سيئات أعمالنا، من يهده الله فلا مضل له ومن يضلل فلا هادي له، وأشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له، وأشهد أن محمدًا عبده ورسوله. يا أيها الذين آمنوا اتقوا الله حق تقاته ولا تموتن إلا وأنتم مسلمون. يا أيها الناس اتقوا ربكم الذي خلقكم من نفس واحدة وخلق منها زوجها وبث منهما رجالا كثيرا ونساء، واتقوا الله الذي تساءلون به والأرحام، إن الله كان عليكم رقيبا. يا أيها الذين آمنوا اتقوا الله وقولوا قولا سديدا يصلح لكم أعمالكم ويغفر لكم ذنوبكم، ومن يطع الله ورسوله فقد فاز فوزا عظيما. أما بعد، فإن أصدق الكلام كلام الله تعالى، وخير الهدي هدي محمد صلى الله عليه وسلم، وشر الأمور محدثاتها، وكل محدثة بدعة، وكل بدعة ضلالة، وكل ضلالة في النار. أيها الأحبة في الله، ما ارتفع شيء إلى السماء أعظم من الإخلاص، وما نزل شيء من السماء أعظم من التوفيق، وبقدر الإخلاص يكون التوفيق. وكما قال بعض السلف: التوفيق ليس بيتا تسكنه، ولا شخصا تعاشره، ولا ثوبا ترتديه، التوفيق غيث من الله سبحانه وتعالى، إن أذن بهطوله عليك لن تشقى أبدا. ولتعلم أن مسألة التوفيق هي المسألة، انظر إلى ذكر الله ما أسهل، وانظر كم من الخلق يذكرون الله تعالى. فاذكروا الله يذكركم واشكروه يزدكم. My dear brothers and sisters, gratefulness of the blessings of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and the evil of sins is the title of our khutbah. شكر النعمة وشؤم المعصية عنوان هذا اللقاء الطيب في هذا اليوم المبارك. My dear brothers and sisters, nothing ascends to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala more rewarding and greater than doing and working solely for the sake of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, ikhlas. And nothing comes from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala down on you as a reward and as a blessing from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala more than tawfiq, guidance, guiding you, taking your hand and make obedience easy for you, make the action that pleases Him so easy, open your heart to do good and make the actions complete. As one of the scholars said, tawfiq is not a friend you take or a cloth you wear or a place you live in. It is like rain, good rain. If Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala pours tawfiq on you, you never despair. You never have hardship. You would live a wonderful life in this world and in the hereafter. And tawfiq comes because of ikhlas. And as much ikhlas you have, as much tawfiq Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala gives you. Imam al-Shafi'i, rahimahullah, we know from what I said that tawfiq comes because of dhikr. Dhikr, remembrance of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Imam al-Shafi'i rahimahullah qal yawm al-qiyamah indama yankashifu al-ghita' an thawabi a'mal al-bashar lam yaraw thawaban afdal min dhikrillah ta'ala fayatahassaru 'inda dhalika aqwam fayaqulun ma kana shay'un aysaru 'alayna min al-dhikr. The day of judgment, when you see the rewards of your actions, your obedience, and you see how much the huge rewards for remembrance of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, some people would wish that they have done so much of it. Some people would wish they have an extra alhamdulillah, an extra subhanallah, an extra astaghfirullah. Some people look at that and go, how easy. You don't have to have wudu, you don't have to dress for it, you don't have to face the qibla. There is no preparation, there is no specific time for it. Anytime you remember Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, He remembers you. That's where really you need to focus. Who are you and who am I for the creator of the universe to mention you by name? Ubay ibn Ka'b radiallahu anhu cried when the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam told him, أمرني الله سبحانه وتعالى أن أقرأ عليك لم يكن الذين كفروا من أهل الكتاب والمشركين منفكين حتى تأتيهم البينة. قال يا رسول الله ذكرني باسمي؟ قال نعم فذكر. أبي بن كعب, the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم, he is أعلمكم بالقرآن. He told him that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala revealed the surah and He wants me to read it on you. He told him, really? Did he actually say my name, Ubay ibn Ka'b? Read it on Ubay ibn Ka'b, or just read it on someone? He said, yes, he said, read it on Ubay ibn Ka'b. He started crying. Who am I and who are you for Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to talk about you? What do you represent, or what do you represent in this universe from the creation of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala? So dhikr, you only have dhikr of someone you know and you love, and you can't be quiet from talking about. قالت بعض العابدات إن السعر إذا رخص اشتراه كل أحد. When the price becomes cheap, everyone buys it. فَإِذَا أَرَدْتَ الرَّاحَ فَاتْرُكَ الرَّاحَ. If you want to rest, don't rest. Life, you're not here to rest. Rest is unemployment. You created to work. You created to serve. You created to remember Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. الحويني جزاه الله خيرا ورحمه قال في قوله سبحانه وتعالى, أبو إسحاق الحويني قال في قوله تعالى إن الصلاة تنهى عن الفحشاء والمنكر ولذكر الله أكبر. قال إذا لم تنهك الصلاة عن الفحشاء والمنكر فذكر الله سبحانه وتعالى أكبر من الصلاة في النهي عن الفحشاء والمنكر, لأن الصلاة شرعت لذكر الله سبحانه وتعالى. وأقم الصلاة لذكري. If salah, which is supposed to keep you from wrongdoings and indecencies and bad actions, if it didn't do the job, and definitely it won't do it because you haven't done it right, he said, then the remembrance of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will do that, because it's bigger than the salah, because salah is meant to be to remember Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala in specific 5 times a day. Where is everybody? How many people here? How many there will be? Did you ever ask yourself, why did you come early? What is today? Does it really matter today, Friday or Saturday or Monday? Those who work the schedule as is. 8 to 8, 8 to 5, 8 to 6. Nothing in between. It's not like close from 1 to 2 or 1 to 2:30 or something. Because Salah and Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is not an overnight. Wallah, it doesn't matter how you look at it, he's not. And if he is, very little. احمل أيها الأخ وأيتها الأخت هما واحدا كيف ترضي الله سبحانه وتعالى وما أسهل إرضاء الله سبحانه وتعالى. إن الله لا يرضى من العبد إذا أكل الأكلة أو شرب الشربة أن يحمل. Say alhamdulillah when you eat or you drink, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is pleased. How easy that to please Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. أخلص أخلص لله سبحانه وتعالى واعبد الله سبحانه وتعالى كما هو يريد واتخذ مقاييس العبادة منهجا لك في هذه الدنيا. The way Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala wants you to worship Him, this is your constitution. This is how you're gonna run your life, in this world. Brothers and sisters, facts. Qarun, we all know him. قارون وأتيناه من الكنوز ما إن مفاتحه لا تنوء بالعصبة أولي القوة. He has so much treasures. The keys for his treasures, group of people need to carry. لم يعلم قارون أن بطاقة الكرت الآلية أكبر وأعظم من مفاتيحه. قارون did not know that we have a debit card. Everybody can carry, and you can put more than the treasure that he has. So we are more blessed than him. Kisra, his throne, ما كان بيعرف إنه الكنباية اللي في بيتنا أفخم من العرش اللي كان يجلس عليه وأريح. The basic sofa that we have in our house is more comfortable than his throne. He didn't know that. He thought, he's it. Herakl, the emperor, Roman emperor, كان يشرب الماء من الفخار. يعني كان يضع الماء في قنينة فخار. يشرب بارد والناس تحزنوا عليها. ما كان يعرف إنه في عندنا ثلاجات بتحط الدنيا كلها فيها وبتبردها. He used to brag that he drinks cold water from a bottle made of ceramic. When people look at him, wow, he's drinking cold water. He doesn't know that we have refrigerators right now. You can make everything in your life cold the way you want it. كذلك الخليفة المنصور أبو جعفر المنصور رضي الله عنه في عباسي خليفة كان الخدم يغلون الماء ويخلطونه له بالماء البارد فيستحم. كان يظن أنه أرفه الناس. ما عرف أنه في عندنا شاور بتحرك في إيدك البارد والحار وكل شيء. ما بدك عبيد ولا بدك شيء. أبو جعفر المنصور used to have people who mix the cold water with the hot water before he showers to make it perfect for him, and he showers, mashallah, this is the best thing in the world. No one has what we have yet. Right nowadays, you enter and you adjust the temperature with your hand. No help, nothing. He used to think he got it all. We got it all. People used to travel for Hajj, ride on a camel for months. Now, in a few hours, you're there. The point I'm trying to make, brothers and sisters, نعيش في حياة أفضل وأعظم من حياة الملوك ولكن الغالب بينضب حظه. We live in a life more luxurious than kings used to live, and majority of us complaining. قول الحمد لله. الحمد لله. الحمد لله على نعم الله. اللهم أعنا على ذكرك وشكرك وحسن عبادتك. We ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to help us, to give us tawfiq, to remember Him, and to be grateful to Him and to worship Him the way He subhanahu wa ta'ala wants us to worship Him. Brothers and sisters, Rasul sallallahu alayhi wa sallam قال أصدق كلمة قالها لبيب على كل شيء ما خلا الله باطل. The most truthful or the biggest truthful word is the word that said by the poet Labib. And he said, everything except Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is going to go useless. كل شيء هالك إلا وجه. Everything is going to go except the face of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. وكل نعيم إلا نعيم الجنة لا محالة زائل. أخطأ شذ في هذه. قال كل نعيم لا محالة زائل ونعيم الجنة لا يزول. صححه عثمان بن مضعون رضي الله عنه عندما قال ألا كل شيء ما خلا الله باطل. قال صدقت أمام شرفاء مكة كفار وهو الوحيد مسلم. وعندما قال وكل شيء لا محالة زائل قال كذبت نعيم الجنة لا يزول. فضربوه ولطموه وآذوه. So he told him, your first one, everything is going to go except Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. I said, you said the truth. The second one said, every blessing is going to go. He said, you're a liar. The blessing of Jannah will not go away. So they beat him up. But it's okay. For the sake of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Brothers and sisters, shu'mul ma'siyah, the evil of sin. Yaqul Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, وَإِذْ أَخَذَ رَبُّكَ مِنْ بَنِي آدَمَ مِنْ ظُهُورِهِمْ ذُرِّيَّتَهُمْ وَأَشْهَدَهُمْ عَلَىٰ أَنفُسِهِمْ أَلَسْتُ بِرَبِّكُمْ قَالُوا بَلَىٰ شَهِدْنَا أَنْ تَقُولُوا يَوْمَ الْقِيَامَةِ كنا عن هذا غافلين. أو تقولوا إنما أشرك آباؤنا من قبل وكنا ذرية من بعدهم. أفتهلكنا بما فعل المبطل. أفتهلكنا بما فعل المبطل. وكذلك نفصل الآيات ولعلهم يرجعون. وقال سبحانه وتعالى وتلك القرى أهلكناهم لما ظلموا وجعلنا لمهلكهم موعدا. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, when He created us, He took the covenant in all of us. Am I not your Lord? Am I not the one that you should worship? Am I not your Creator? Am I not your sustainer? قالوا بلى شهدنا. Yes, O Allah, you are. Don't come one day and say, it's my parents who made me mushrik. I wasn't born in a Muslim family, that's why I'm a mushrik. Not a good excuse, not accepted. Don't come and say, I didn't know about it. Well, it may apply for some, but not for all. Don't come and say, I said La ilaha illallah. But pay attention to what words you utter with that nullifies and negates La ilaha illallah. It's not as simple as you think, brothers and sisters. It's not as simple as you think once you are a Muslim, you're always a Muslim. Don't ever think just because you are doing certain worship that, mashallah, you took care of it. Wallahi, some of us enter and exit daily from Islam. They don't know it. And from the people of knowledge too. Unfortunate. You know why? Because Tawheed is the last thing on their agenda to digest and understand what it is and how you maintain it and what makes you exit out of it. How? Imagine Quraysh came to Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam. They told him, we worship your God 1 year. You worship ours 1 week or 1 month. Good deal, right? Hey, all Quraysh would become Muslim for 1 year. You never know who's going to stay because they're going to taste the sweetness of it. And we'll have more Muslims. People who have zero understanding of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala would think so. But those who know Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, He's not in need for your Islam and not worried about your kufr, doesn't care for either one of those because none of them benefit Him or harm Him. He wants you to follow what He wants, not what you think and what you like. Don't compare Him to you. This pleases you, that means it pleases Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. No. You don't know Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. When Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala tells you, you're created and everything created for La ilaha illallah, you need to value that word. You need to understand that word. You need to live and die on that word. You need to stay 10 miles away from anything that touches or messes with that word, even remotely. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, عندما أخبرنا سبحانه وتعالى بحرمة الزنا لم يكن لا تزنوا قال ولا تقربوا الزنا ولا تقربوا الزنا لا تنظر ولا تتكلم ولا تلمس ولا 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 كل نوع من أنواع الزنا زنا fornication. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said do not commit fornication. No, He said don't get close to it. Don't look, don't touch, don't walk, don't do anything that gets you closer to committing the zina. And you think that shirk is not more important to be the farthest from it? No, brother, my intention. Take your intention and trash it if it's not according to the sunnah. I hope that's clear. Intention needs action, and action needs intention. One without the other, trash. So yeah, happy holiday, brother.
Just kind word. Is this what Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala wants? Is this what Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala told you? Prophet Muhammad used to do it, right? He's more keen, He's more loving, He's more merciful. Why? He said, they have their holidays and we have ours, they have their Eid and we have our Eid. لِكُلِّ قَوْمٍ Do theirs and ours. Do you know what you say? When you say Happy Christmas or Merry Christmas or Happy Holiday, do you think about it? Allah al-Azim It amazes me. Loving people and treating people and caring for people and da'wah, you can do all of that without committing kufr, without falling in shirk. Faith is in the heart. If he does it, I do it. If he comes to me with his girlfriend, I go visit him with my girlfriend because he stepped down and came and did. If he congratulates me for my Eid and he committed kufr and he became a kafir in his religion, I would do the same because, you know, he was kind to me, so I'll be kind to him. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala qal, وَقَالُوا اتَّخَذَ الرَّحْمَنُ وَلَدًا لَقَدْ جِئْتُمْ شَيْئًا إِدًّا تكاد السماوات يتفطرن منه وتنشق الأرض وتخر الجبال هدا أن دعوا للرحمن ولدا. The sky, the earth, the mountain crushed from the word Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has a son. وينذر الذين قالوا اتخذ الله ولدا ما لهم به من علم ولا لآبائهم كبرت كلمة تخرج من أفواههم إن يقولون إلا كذبا وأنت تأتي وتقول مبروك. ما شاء الله، فهمان زلمة، فهمان وعارف دينه ومتقرب لله وبده يدعو وبده يجيب وبده يسلم وبده يدخل الجنة، والله أبعد ما تكون منها. لا يدخل الجنة إلا مؤمن. Brothers, there is nothing better than tawheed and nothing worse than shirk. That's not my words. That's what Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala told us. You don't compromise your faith or your love or anything with that. It's in your heart. And at the same time, we're not hypocrites. It's not I say something and I mean it's something else. It's not by intention. It is by action too. You want to get people closer to you, show them your manners. Show them your manners. Show them your justice. Show them your love and care without falling in something only the heart knows about it. Brothers and sisters, Adam alayhi salam, because of a small sin, just like you passing by, you see a tree, it's not your tree, you take something, or in the store you take something and you eat it. This is haram, you stole it. He did something like that. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala kicked him out of heaven to live in this life and suffer and work so he can go back to it. Iblis, alayhi la'natullah, Iblis, all he did is bow for him. He said, why should I bow for him? I'm better than him. In hell permanently. And then you come and you say, what do I do? It's a small sin. We don't know Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. الحمد لله حمدا يوافي نعمه ويدفع نقمه واشهد ان لا اله الا الله واشهد ان محمدا عبده ورسوله شكر النعمه وشؤم المعصيه. My dear brothers and sisters, show your gratitude of the ni'am that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala blessed us with and be grateful to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Remember Him in everything and anywhere you go and be aware of the disobedience of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. There is no such a thing as small sin and big sin in the eyes of the believer. Even though when it comes to Islamic rulings you might find that, but those who know Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, they equate the disobedience. You are disobedient, you are disobedient to your Creator. That's huge, regardless of how small it is. We know all the nations that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala destroyed, it's because sins, and some of those sins are small in our eyes, but yet
huge in the eyes of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. The very most important thing that you can do as a believer is to enjoin good and forbid evil. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, when He puts you in authority or puts you in charge, الَّذِينَ إِن مَكَّنَّاهُمْ فِي الْأَرْضِ أَقَامُوا الصَّلَاةِ وَأَمَرُوا بِالْمَعْرُوفِ وَنَهَوْا عَنِ الْمُنكَرِ. Establish salah and immediately enjoin good and forbid evil, and there is nothing bigger than evil of shirk in Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala associating partners. لا يمكن أن هي في هذا القول لا يمكن أن تقوم لمسلم قائمة ولا أن تكون له شخصية متميزة ولا جرأة في الحق إلا إذا فهم وفهم بتعمق معنى لا إله إلا الله. Wallahi, you would never be distinguished and you would never have the courage and you would never worship Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala the way He deserves unless you know and deeply you know what La ilaha illallah means. This is a fact. There are two pools for the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. One in this dunya and one in the hereafter. We all know the hereafter. The one in dunya is sunnah. Look at the sunnah of the Prophet ﷺ. How did he deal in holidays? And what did he say? And what did he do? And what offers he has and how he reacted? You would understand the majority of what we do is wrong and not according to the sunnah. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala doesn't like it. Hold fast to the Quran and hold fast to the Sunnah, and know that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala swore 11 times in Surah Al-Shams. 11 times that the only successful person, قَدْ أَفْلَحَ مَنْ زَكَّاهَا, the one who purifies himself with righteous deeds, with getting close to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and staying away from the haram, and the one who ruins his life and perishes and puts it in hell is the one who does the other way. Brothers and sisters, Islam is a way of life, and Islam is pleasure from A to Z to Muslims and non-Muslims in actions and everything. Every rule in Islam is perfect, and you don't need to change or alter or think or add or anything. Do it as is. It will accomplish the job that you're looking for in your crooked way. Follow the straight path. وَأَنَّ هَذَا صِرَاطِي مُسْتَقِيمًا فَاتَّبِعُوهُ وَلَا تَتَّبِعُوا السُّبُلَ فَتَفَرَّقَ بِكُمْ عَنْ سَبِيلِهِ ذَلِكُمْ وَصَّاكُمْ بِهِ لَعَلَّكُمْ تَتَّقُونَ. Understand what taqwa is? It is by following الصراط المستقيم. أسأل الله سبحانه وتعالى أن يجعلنا من أهل الصراط المستقيم وأن يجعلنا من الذين يستمعون القول فيتبعون أحسنه أولئك الذين هداهم الله وأولئك هم أولو الألباب. اللهم آت نفوسنا تقواها وزكها أنت خير من زكاها أنت وليها ومولاها. ربنا آتنا في الدنيا حسنة وفي الآخرة حسنة وقنا عذاب النار. سبحانك اللهم وبحمدك, أشهد أن لا إله إلا أنت, أستغفرك وأتوب إليك, وأقم الصلاة.